In this lecture, I will introduce simple methods to analyze service processes. To start, it can be useful to look at services from two different perspectives, the customer perspective and the production perspective. From the customer perspective, we would analyze the experienced outcome by looking at steps in the service journey. From the production perspective, we would analyze the transformation processes and support processes needed to deliver the service.
Let's start with the customer experience. One model, the so-called Servuction model, differentiates four factors that impact the experience of a customer. The first factor is the so-called Servicescape and describes the place where the service is consumed. The Servicescape is defined by the layout, noise and smell, decor, and other things customers can sense. The second factor is the frontline personnel who the customer interacts with. The third factor is other customers, and the fourth covers the invisible back office organizations and systems. I would add one more factor to these four, the customer, him or herself. The expectations of the customer affect the service experience. To capture this point, another model is useful. The gap model is a process model of the customer's experience. It starts with expectations prior to the service and then describes how the service leads to perceptions of the service quality, which finally leads to a service experience, depending on the degree of match or mismatch between expectations and the perception. If the perception is equal to the expectations, the customer is satisfied. If the perception is lower than the expectation, the customer is dissatisfied. And if the perception is higher than the expectation, then the customer is delighted. So, what can we do with this model? Well, if there's a mismatch between perceptions and expectations, it is usually caused by either a mismatch between expectations and the service, which we call gap one, and or a mismatch between the service and customer's perceptions of it, which we can call gap two. The first gap is due to either an unrealistic customer expectation or our own limited understanding of what the customer would expect. For example, overpromising marketing may raise expectations above what we can deliver. It could also be due to bad service design. For example, we could design a service which is extremely hard to deliver consistently. One way to close this gap would be to create better standards and communicate them clearly to customers. The second gap stems from either bad service delivery or customers perceiving the service inappropriately. As I'm sure you have noticed, service companies can have a wide variety in service delivery. Just check TripAdvisor. The same hotel can receive a 1-star review and a 5-star review on the same day. Providing consistent and high-quality service processes can help close the second gap. And when things go wrong, as they necessarily will, service companies must be good at service recovery processes. Handling claims and generally turn a negative service experience into a neutral or positive one is key to service success. And don't forget to learn from failure. Now, let's shift to an operational perspective. Glenna Lynn Shostak has suggested a useful framework for mapping processes with a high service element, namely service blueprinting. Service blueprints take different visual forms, but generally they separate the service into physical evidence, customer actions, front office customer interaction, either through frontline staff or technology such as web pages or machines, back office processes dealing with the customer, and support processes that do not involve the customer. Arrows are used to show links between the processes. The line of interaction identifies when a customer interacts with the front office. Note, every time that happens, there's a so-called moment of truth, which informs the customer's perception of the service. The line of visibility splits back office and front office operations. And the line of internal interaction splits back office and support processes. A service blueprint is a planning tool that provides guidance on how to design and deliver a service.
So, that's it. Three straightforward methods to help you analyze service processes. Servuction, the gap model, and the service blueprint. I hope you were delighted.